Hi, it's Zulfin. In this video, we're gonna model parts in Autodesk Inventor, specifically the 2022 version. But if you have the older or the newer version, the feature is basically the same, so don't worry. In the previous video, we already create these part here, which are part number 1 and part number 2. So on this occasion, we're gonna make this part, which is part number 3. But first up, as we can see, this part has a basic shape of cylindrical, so you might think that it's gonna be easier if we make it by using revolve tool. But in my opinion, using revolve tool to create a feature that can be made by extrusion will make you create more complex sketches, and it will take more time. So I'm gonna using revolve tool to make this feature, and using extrude to make this feature and the rest of it. Also, we're gonna use a tool called circular pattern to make these features. Let's go back to the Autodesk Inventor. As usual, make a new part by clicking the new button and select the metric folder here, then choose the standard millimeters.ipt. So we're gonna make this feature first. Create a sketch, choose the XY plane here. Make a circle with 215 millimeters in diameter. Finish sketch and extrude. Fill 6 millimeters here, and then click OK. Create a sketch again on this face. Make a circle with 115 millimeters in diameter. Click Finish Sketch. If we see the drawing, this feature doesn't have the length dimension, so you can use the basic formula like addition, subtraction, multiply, or division using the existing dimension. So we're gonna make the feature by 320, take away by this dimension, and this dimension. So it's gonna be 320. Minus opening bracket 22, plus 6, plus 10, closing bracket. Then click OK. Create a sketch on this face. Make a circle with 166 millimeters in diameter. And finish sketch, then extrude. Fill the dimension with 10, then enter. Next, we're gonna make this feature by using revolve tool. Select the YZ plane, and create a sketch here. Press the F7 to cut the body temporarily, then click Project Cut Edge, and make the projected object into construction line. We're gonna use this line, so make it a regular line. And press the L button, then make a sketch just like the drawing. Make this line a center line. Then give the sketch dimensions. Finish sketch and execute the revolve tool. Because there is only one active sketch here, so it automatically selects the closed profile as the revolve profile, and the center line is the revolve axis. Then click OK. Next, we're gonna make this ratchet feature by using these dimensions. Create a sketch on this face. Click Project Cut Edge, and make a construction line. Press F7. And I have a little tips for you, if you make a circle, and think that finding the center point is kind of difficult. you can use the offset tool, as we can see we have the projected circle here. Just press the O button, then click and drag the circle, and that's it, you got your circle. Give the circle dimension, here is 128. Then make it as a construction line. Then make a sketch of only one of these ratchet piece. Make a diagonal line like this. Then make an arc using the 3 points arc tool. Trim a necessary object. Create a line as a guideline. And give the sketch dimensions. As we can see here, we can still drag this arc. It shows that this sketch is not fully constrained. So make a line here. Let's see the drawing. What we have to do is dividing 360 degrees by the number of teeth here. Let's give this angle dimension. 360 divided by 16, then press enter. Then using the center point arc tool, make an inner line of the ratchet piece. Finish sketch and extrude. Click to option here and click this face. Then click OK. Next up is arraying this feature like this. So click circular pattern, feature button is already active here, so click this feature. Click rotation axis here, and choose any cylinder here, as long as it's concentric with the axis you want. Fill this with the number of teeth which is 16, and then click OK. Now, we're gonna make this inner hole here. As we can see, we can know about this hole depth by only this dimension. So we're gonna make this hole first. Create a sketch on this face. Finish sketch and extrude. Select cut and fill the depth with 3 plus 18 plus 19. Then click OK. Next, create a sketch on the other side. Make a circle with 115 minus 16 in diameter. Finish sketch and extrude. Click two distance option here. Select this face, and then click OK. Go ahead, we're gonna make this feature. Create a sketch on this face. Click Project Cut Edge, and make a construction line. Create two circles by offsetting this projected circle. Give the inner circle dimension 126 millimeters. And the distance between these circles is 13.5 millimeters. Make two lines like this. Then make a horizontal line dividing these two lines and make it as a construction line. Click symmetric constraint here. And select the first line, the second line, and the horizontal line. So if you drag one of the lines, it's gonna be like this. Then give it dimension. Next, we're gonna make the center point of this thread. Make a diagonal line here, and give it dimension. Place a point on the end of the line. Then, make the line 45 degrees from the horizontal line. Trim the unnecessary objects. Finish sketch. And execute the extrude command. Select this profile and select cut, then fill 1 mm in the box. We also want to use the sketch as the hole point, but the sketch is being consumed by the extrusion. So click this plus button here. Right-click on the sketch, then click Share Sketch, so the sketch will appear again. Press H button to use the hole tool. Choose Who for the Determine, then select this face. Then select M12 from Isometric Profile. And click OK. We're gonna ray this feature, but let's hide the sketch first. You can click the circular pattern button here, or use the Ctrl-Shift-O shortcut. Select these feature. And select this face as the rotation axis, then fill the box with 4. Then click OK. Next, we're gonna make this strut hole here. But as we can see, the starting face of the hole is not flat. Do we have to make a plane first on here? No, you don't have to. You can use the origin plane here. Then make a sketch on it. Select the Z-axis and click Project Geometry. Then also project this line for the dimension datum. Add point here, then give it 50 millimeters from this line. Click Finish Sketch. Then we're gonna make a hole with an upward direction. Press H button. Then select Through All here. Then select Flipped for the direction. Choose M10 from here. Then click OK. Next, you can see that there is some fillet here. And only one chamfer here. So let's make the fillet first by click the fillet tool here. Or you can just press F button on your keyboard. Change the dimension with 3 mm, then select all the edge that has 3 mm fillet. And click Apply, then change the dimension with 5 mm. Select this edge, and click OK. Next, let's make the chamfer, click the chamfer tool here. Or you can also use Ctrl-Shift-K shortcut. It's already 2 mm, so click this edge, then click OK. Well, that's it, give it a try. If there is any question about this video, please let me know. See you on the next video.